Shabbat Shalom. Yesterday, I got an email from a childhood friend, someone I've known since I was about 3 years old, and he's putting together a gift for his mother. I won't mention his name because I want to keep it a secret from his mother. I don't want the surprise to be spoiled. But he was asking me and a couple of our closest friends to send him photos of us with our moms. So he said, do you have a picture of you and your mom, digital photo that you can send me? And I said, yeah, of course, let me just, you know, I'll get it right to you. So I don't know if you use like Google Photos or iPhoto. You guys have heard of digital photography? Yeah, okay. Everybody's using these kinds of products, and it's pretty amazing. I don't know if you've seen this functionality on Google Photos. It has face recognition software, which actually should creep you out a little bit, because it will, on every photo that you take, it will identify the faces. And then if you tell them the name of one of the people in your photos, it will compare it to all the photos in your library, and then it will group all those photos by person. It's actually a really nifty thing if you're looking for photos for maybe a bat mitzvah montage, say, you're set, or you've got a big milestone birthday. So, but it also means that Google just knows a little bit more about you, and I know Google's watching right now, because we're on YouTube, and Facebook as well. So I went to my Google Photos, and I typed in my mom's name, and there were only a few photos of my mother in my Google Photos because my mom died 18 years ago and digital photography existed, but almost all of my photos of my mom are, kids, you remember the old-fashioned photos? You had film. I remember once, a couple of years ago, one of my daughters, I guess it was maybe 6 or 7 years ago, my daughter found a film canister in a drawer somewhere, pulled it out and pulled the film out, which at first I was like, no, and then I realized, what difference does it make? I'm never going to use that film. And she pulled all the film out and she was like, what is this? So I had to explain it to her. So I'm looking in the Google Photos and I get a message. I found about 4 photos and they weren't that great. And then it said, there doesn't appear to be any additional photos of Hermine Zweibach. And it made me sad. It reminded me of how many years have passed. And then I thought about this week's Torah portion, and guess what? I felt better. That's the great thing about our tradition, and it's a beautiful thing about being steeped in the tradition, because you can find comfort and solace. So I thought about Parashat Yitro, this week's Torah portion, which includes the Big Ten. The Ten Commandments are found in this week's Torah portion. And I thought, of course, about the fifth commandment, Kabed et avicha ve'et imecha. You should honor your father and your mother. And then it tells us, Lema'an ya'arichun yamecha al ha'adama asher Adonai Elohecha notein lach. So that your days will be lengthened and you will long endure on the land that the eternal your God is going to give you. Commentators talk about both parts of that verse. What does it mean to honor your mother and your father? And the big one, and I know there are some people here with their parents, so here's the big one. You know what the big thing the Talmud says about honoring your parents is? When they come into the room, Alexis, you stand. That's the big thing. When you come into the room, if you're a parent, the kids are supposed to stand, and that's how most of us do it, right? You see mom or dad come in. My kids won't look up from their iPhones when I come into the room. And then it says that when they're older and they have trouble getting around, in the Talmud it says you should help them. And if they ever need help eating when they're older, you should help them with that. And so there's some specific things. But the second half of the verse is really interesting too, because the commentators want to know, do we take it literally? It says, if you honor your parents, you'll live a long life. But we know that if we take that literally, there are problems. We know people who are wonderful children and who honor their parents in a very deep way, and they die young. It can't be. So one of the commentators, Sforno, says that we don't have to understand it literally to refer to this world. And he takes it to mean Olam Haba. He said, if you honor your mother and your father in this world, then you will have a place in the world to come, which is the world to come, Cantor. Heaven. Olam Haba. It's Encino, there you go. just right there, and it's just a little slice of heaven. So if you honor your parents in this world, your days will be lengthened in the world to come. That's how Sforno understands it. And I was thinking about the way time works. And another throwback, I was talking about non-digital photography, actual film photography. Who remembers the movie The Jerk? Steve Martin. Great movie. Tried to get my kids to watch it, and it was too slow for them because movies today, you know, if there's not a cut, these kids today, what's happening to me? I'm like, these kids, if it's not a cut every 11 seconds, you know, they can't watch it. So it was too slow for them. But there's that great scene when he's in the bathtub and he's thinking about time, and he's talking about, you know, when we first met, it was like a month, and then you were gone for a few days, and that felt like 2 years. And he's just talking about the way time works. And I was thinking about that today, and I was thinking about this verse. Because maybe the way we understand length of days is not literal days and not heaven, although it could mean that, but it's about how we experience time. And then I thought about my mom again. So it's been 18 years since I saw my mother, and yet she's part of my life every day. So even though she only had 59 years on this earth, it's almost like she got an extra 18 already. So the days have been lengthened. I thought about my Grandpa Jake, and I have no digital pictures of Grandpa Jake. He died in 1983, and I didn't know from digital photography. So if I didn't even bother searching him up on my Google Photos. But if I had, it would have said, there doesn't appear to be any photos of Jake Davis. And he's been gone for more than 40 years, and yet it's like he's still here. So I want to suggest to us that when we honor those close to us, when we love people deeply, they could be gone for a week, they could be gone for a month, they could be gone for 20 years, and I know there are people here tonight who are mourning loved ones who are gone, and some people are here tonight because there's a yard site, and it might be 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, but that person and you in some ways have been given length of days because they're still present in your lives. And the final thing I want to connect to is our rabbi, our teacher, Isaiah Zeldin, whom we lost this week. After many, many days on this earth, 97 and a half years, the Mishnah in Bava Metzia teaches us that you're supposed to honor your teachers as you would honor your parents. In fact, it even suggests that maybe you should honor your teachers, your rabbis, even a little bit more than you should honor your parents. And I think it would be very self-serving for me to make that claim. So let me just make that claim. You should honor your teachers even more than you would honor. At least I make the claim to my own children. I say, look, I'm your father and I'm a rabbi for you, so I should get double honor. But it explains that you should honor your teacher so much because your parents brought you into this world. The teacher brings you into the world to come. A good teacher will give you the life lessons and the skills to bring you into a world of meaning and maybe even to heaven. And I'd like to think that good parents are doing that every day. Good parents are the best teachers for their children. But when we think about Rabbi Zeldin's legacy and what he's done for us, what he's done for this community, for so many of you personally, I only knew him for 6 years or so, but I've talked to people who have shared memories that go back five decades with Rabbi Zeldin and even more. And so six decades, I heard. So those experiences and those relationships are going to last. And what I think should comfort us is that 10 years from now, 20 years from now, 30 years from now, when we're commemorating the yard site of our rabbi, length of days, he'll still be present for us, and he'll still be present in the stories that we tell, and he'll still be present in this community that he helped build. All of that should bring us comfort. We honor those we love when we remember them, when we live their values, when we tell their stories. May the way we remember bring them and us kavod, honor, now and forever.